Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan selamat pagi semua. Diharap semuanya berada dalam keadaan sihat hendaknya dan boleh dengar saya ya. Saya tak pasti sama ada moderator will start this session ataupun saya will start terus. Boleh ah thank you Dr. Ramadhan Dr. Aman. Boleh saya mula Dr. Aman ya? Dah pukul 10 1 minit dah. Asyik. Okey. Terima kasih, Dr. Aman.
Assalamualaikum and a very good morning to all participants. My name is Muhammad Shahnawi bin Muhammad Firoz. I am the moderator for today's webinar sessions. This morning, this webinar session for this morning is for today's is evaluating thesis for master's by research. Our speaker for today is Dr. Akhisan Haji Dahlan from the Faculty of Health and Health and Sciences. The scenario of IPSIS currently, we have the drops of enrollment since compared to last year, 2019. And perhaps today will be a good platform for every one of us to share our knowledge and experiences in actually how to boost the enrollment, especially in to strengthen the thesis evaluations and how it can be actually a good factor for us to boost the enrollment. So without further ado, we would like to have Dr. Akhisan Haji Dahlan on the platform to start the seminar. Thank you.
Terima kasih banyak Dr. Shah. Thank you very much Dr. Shah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan selamat pagi. Thank you very much for attending this IPSIS webinar series, Upskilling Postgraduate Supervisions and Assessment. The topic that I'm going to present today is just like a sharing experience and also some knowledge that I gained throughout evaluating thesis of master students, master by research. Okay. All right. On 7 May 2018, I attended a course organized by UiTM, IPSIS, entitled Effective Postgraduate Examinations. And one of the speakers talked about this is delight, this is fright. One the speaker is Professor Dr. Hadariah Bahrod, and I'm so impressed with her presentations. And I use it to practice to evaluate thesis students. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to share some of her slides and also experience in evaluating thesis for master by research among UiTM students and also students from other universities. All right, with permission, I would like to acknowledge some of the content of this presentation are from Hadariah's slide. If you have attended this presentation, I'm sorry about it, but let's just perceive it as revisions kind of sessions. Don't worry, I don't have many slides, so it's going to be a very quick presentation, and I hope that knowledge gained today can be practiced ataupun ambil sebahagian daripadanya to be practiced during evaluating thesis for master by research. This is my outline of the presentations. Basically, examiner, whether you want to accept or decline, forms to evaluate, and process of evaluation, and some tips. First and foremost, I would like to congratulate if you are being appointed to be an external or internal examiner for postgraduate thesis. It is important and also significant milestone for any academicians. It is an acknowledgement to you all. Tania, but the question is whether you want to accept ataupun decline. Some people use appointed, some people use invitations, but invitation tu, jemputan tu, sometimes kita boleh tolak. Appointed tu rasa the strong word rather than invited. But, so I like to use appointed. So the question is whether you want to accept ataupun decline. Nak terima atau tidak. Alright, kalau ikut-ikut hati nak terima lah sebab it is a significant milestone for us as academicians. Alright. Okay, maybe you will... Before you accept or decline, you have to think few other things, yeah? For example, you have to think whether you are in the field. You can accept it if you are really, really in the field and you know the subject materials, yeah? And you, quote-unquote, expert in the fields, yeah? B, if you really can dedicate the time, ada masa untuk tanda, lihat, baca thesis tersebut. Dan yang ketiga, you ada feeling natural on the student and also to the supervisor. Kalau you ada preconceived ideas about the student, you know the student earlier, yeah, saya rasa you have to decline lah. Dan of course, you are willing to share atau learn from student ataupun accept new informations, yeah. Dan saya fikir kita perlu what you call this consider to decline if kita not even in the field ataupun even vaguely in the field ataupun kita terlalu busy, you are too busy and you can't think can't meet the deadline tu. Yeah, deadline biasanya untuk master adalah 6 minggu gitu, so within 6 weeks tu we have to submit the report to the KPPS, Ketua Pusat Pengajian Siswazah. Sometimes apa yang berlaku, selalu sibuk, KPPS terpaksa kejar kita dan kita rasa tertekan, dan juga KPPS dan juga student juga rasa tertekan. Right, kalau kita ada strong feeling, especially a negative towards the candidates or the supervisor, saya rasa kita perlu decline lah. Ya, sebab ada preconceived ideas atau prejudice ideas, ya. Lebih baik kita tak tahu student tu, that is much more better. Kalau kita yang jenis yang keras kepala, saya guna perkataan itulah, kalau kita yang tak really new open to new knowledge dan suka argue dan selalu fikir always right kind of things, ya. Yeah. Sebab ialah kadang-kadang ada gap between pensyarah dengan juga student. So gap itu kadang-kadang agak besar, ya. Yeah. Alright, dan not fit into criteria deemed by IPSIS lah. Excuse me. Dan kalau boleh kita don't accept it for ego trip lah, kita nak show we are the best ataupun flaunt your superiority and knowledge or any other personal agenda. Kalau we have that issue ataupun criteria ataupun pengalaman ataupun agenda, lebih baik kita decline to evaluate the thesis, yeah. After all, it is a sharing and learning process. Kita share our experience and so we learn and relearn from the students. Right, there are many forms evaluated ataupun used by UiTM. For example lah, satu adalah laporan. This could be different if you are accepting to evaluate thesis from student from any other universities, yeah. Tapi di UiTM kita ada tiga borang yang selalu kita gunakan. One is laporan pemeriksa thesis ataupun thesis examiner report. Another one is perakuan pemeriksa thesis atau examiner concluding statements. Saya tak pasti kenapa translation dia tu berbeza sikit. Alright, dan yang ketiga adalah borang pencalonan oleh pemeriksa untuk anugerah inovasi reka cipta bagi thesis sarjana ataupun PhD, iaitu examiner nomination for innovation and invention award in master and PhD thesis. Berikut adalah borang-borangnya. For example, ini adalah borang yang selalu kita jumpa, laporan pemeriksa thesis. Yeah, dia ada banyak section, dia ada guided assessment dan juga ada open assessment, and each sections tu ada kriteria-kriteria tertentu. For example, robustness of the thesis, quality of thesis, and also originality and scholarly. Right, these are the aspect of assessment in the guided assessment, robustness of the thesis, title of thesis, and so on. So apa yang berlaku adalah dalam evaluation tu ada kotak 1, 2, 3, 4 dan 5. Ya, poor, slightly, reasonable, adequate dan juga clear, dan juga komen yang perlu kita masukkan. Borang-borang ini perlu dihantar balik kepada KPPS untuk arrangement of by bubble say. Alright, robustness of the thesis, quality of the thesis, and originality and scholarly and scholarly discourses, and overall, and juga the open assessment, ya, yang perlu kita tulis apa-apa assessment itu. Alright, dan selalunya yang open assessment ni lebih banyak daripada guided assessment, ya, which is quite fine. Borang kedua adalah yang ini, iaitu perakuan pemeriksa thesis ataupun examiner concluding statement, di mana kita akan letakkan sama ada student tersebut pass atau lulus dengan pembetulan minor, ya, lulus dengan pembetulan major, lulus dengan pembetulan major dan reviva dan also gagal. Lulus dengan pembetulan minor, duration pembetulannya biasanya adalah 6 bulan bergantung kepada universiti tersebut, dan saya tahu UiTM adalah 6 bulan. Lulus dengan pembetulan major adalah major sama ada with or without reviva adalah selama 1 tahun ataupun 12 bulan. Okay, selalunya ada dua proses yang kita lakukan untuk evaluation. Satu adalah evaluations of the thesis itself. Ya, yang kedua ada evaluation during viva voce. Ya, right. Saya akan go through satu persatu dan hopefully we get some ideas. Okay, evaluation of thesis, ada evaluation of thesis yang hard copy tu, ada tiga options lah yang selalu saya gunakan dan yang saya tahu, yang saya pelajari, yang saya praktiskan. Tiga option macam mana nak evaluate tu, ya. Pertama sekali adalah kita option pertama, kedua dan ketiga. Saya akan go through setiap satunya. Alright. Tetapi please be cautious that all decision yang written in the concluding statement tu adalah tidak final, ya. Yeah? Dia boleh bertukar semasa viva voce. Kita boleh tunggu until clarification, but for the sake of submitting the report, kita kena tick dulu. But sama ada lulus atau lulus dengan pembetulan minor atau lulus dengan pembetulan major dan sebagainya. Tetapi kita boleh tukar. Kita boleh tukar at any time, semasa viva voce, semasa deliberation atau listening to clarification ataupun justification atau explanation from the student. So we can change it any time. Alright. Option pertama adalah how you going to evaluate adalah macam ini, ya. Pertama sekali kita baca all the chapters. Kita terima saja thesis, satu thesis macam ni. Kita terima saja thesis, lepas tu kita akan baca semua chapter. Baca dulu. Baca daripada beginning sampailah summary, sampailah conclusion and recommendations. At the same time, kita write comments. Masa kita baca tu, kita comment, tulis dekat dalam thesis tersebut, ya. Dan lepas tu evaluate, lepas tu masukkan dalam borang yang thesis evaluation form itu. Lepas tu kita mark examiner concluding statement dan write additional feedback yang di dalam borang yang borang evaluations thesis report tersebut, ya. Option ini adalah mengambil masa yang lama lah, honestly. Ya, mengambil masa yang lama. At the same time, kadang-kadang kita confused. Kita take time to baca semua, kemudian baru komen, kemudian baru masukkan dalam borang tersebut. Ya, this will take a long time. Ya, and also sometimes bila kita dah habis tu, kita tak ingat apa apa dalam literature reviewnya, dalam introduction kita tak ingat, then we have to go through back, balik semula. Ya, yeah? Optionnya macam itu. Kita baca semua chapter dulu, lepas tu tulis komen dalam thesis tersebut, lepas tu masukkan dalam borang evaluation, lepas tu mark examiner concluding statement, sama ada major, minor ataupun reviver and so on. Lepas tu kita write additional feedback dekat borang tersebut. Option ini memang agak lambat sedikit dan takes a long time, ya. Yeah? Option kedua adalah look at the examiner report forms. Kita tengok borang tadi tu, yang borang dekat atas ni. Yep, borang yang ini. Kita go one by one, kita tengok thesis tersebut. Ya, yeah, kita tengok borang ni satu per satu. Ya. Yeah. Kita tengok satu persatu dan juga tuliskan komennya. Alright, so basically thesisnya kita baca, kita buka chapter yang berkaitan dengan thesis tersebut dan kita tulis tulis komen dekat sini dan terus masukkan dekat sini. So this is a better option than option pertama sebab dia macam selari. Every time kita baca, kita akan tulis komen dekat thesis tersebut dan also kita akan tulis dekat borang borang report forms tu. Ya. Yeah? Tapi borang report forms tu perlu ada additional feedback yang perlu kita tulis dekat separate forms, which is quite okay. Selepas kita baca each section tu, action section tu kita letakkan dalam borang tersebut, lepas tu kita akan mark the examiner concluding statement sama ada kita nak beli major, minor ataupun reviver and so on. Dan lepas tu of course kita kena hantar borang tersebut kepada KPPS. Option ketiga is very interesting. Ini daripada Prof. Dr. Hadariah. Alright, pertama sekali kita read the teaser, the meat, the beautifier. Lepas tu write comment. Ya, yeah, kita tengok thesis tu, kita read the teaser dulu. The meat, the beautifier dan write comment dekat thesis tersebut. Masukkan dalam borang report forms dan mark concluding statement dan write additional feedback. Tapi apa itu teaser, apa itu meet, apa itu beautifier. Alright. So basically this is common sequence of reading thesis lah. Right. So kita ada title, kita ada acknowledgement, kita ada abstract dan objective and scope of the limitation. Ini become the teaser. Sebab dia akan give first impressions. The meat atau dagingnya adalah methodology, result, discussion and conclusion. Itu meat dia. Dan dia, yang beautifier dia adalah introduction, literature review, format and languages and the rest, references lah, appendices and so on, ya. Yeah? Alright, so apa yang kita perlu buat adalah the teaser ni, alright, terdiri daripada title, abstract, objective and scope and limitation. Kita baca, dapat thesis, kita baca teaser dulu. Kita tengok title dia, kita tengok abstract dia, kita tengok objective dia, scope and limitations-nya. Alright, dalam ini tak ada, dalam yang teaser ni tak ada what you call this, tak ada acknowledgement. Satu perkara tentang bila saya baca thesis student, I like to see the acknowledgement sebab acknowledgement ni very very kata orang sangat menyentuh perasaan sometimes. Dia acknowledge supervisor dia of course, lepas tu acknowledge parents dia, menceritakan tentang all the difficulties and hardships and also experience, yeah. This gives some ideas about how hard the student doing their thesis lah. A glimpse of idea, not the real ideas lah of course, yeah. Then of course, yeah, kita tengok abstractnya. Daripada abstractnya, kita boleh tahu the overall, apa yang cuba nak sampaikan, apa objektif secara keseluruhan dan sebagainya. Lepas tu kita go untuk objektifnya, yang detailnya, scope and limitations, ya. Yeah. Biasanya apa yang berlaku adalah title-nya ties dengan abstracts, ya. Yeah. Method, result tie dengan discussion. Objektifnya tie dengan conclusion. Figures and tables are complementary, reference are coherent and correct. Correctly written. The meat of the thesis terdiri daripada methodology, result, discussion and also conclusions. Kita tengok meat dia. Kita tengok teaser dia dulu, lepas tu kita tengok meat dia. Kita tengok methodology dia, result dia, discussionnya and conclusion. So apa yang kita buat, kita buka thesisnya Then kita write, baca metodologi, write comment straight away there. Lepas tu letakkan dalam borang evaluation form tersebut. Lepas tu discussion and conclusion. Lepas tu the rest kita boleh tengok beautifier, introductions, references, supplementary data, appendices and format and languages. Alright. The question is, masa kita baca teaser dia tu, which consists of title, abstract, objective, scope and limitation and so acknowledgement, adakah kita tickled by the teaser? Adakah kita interested to read the rest? Ya, yeah? Biasanya ini teaser ini akan increase our desire to read more. Kalau teasernya pun tidak tickled, tidak, we are not being tickled by the teaser, so kita pun rasa nak baca thesis itu agak lambat dan juga agak tidak passionate to read the thesis, ya. Yeah? Alright, lepas kita going through the good teaser, kita akan dapat pretty good ideas what the thesis is about, what the story is presented in the thesis. Kita boleh imagine what would be dished out in the chapters dalam meatnya, iaitu dalam metodologi, dalam result and discussions, ya. Yeah? Alright, then be able to speculate the main point in the conclusions. Ya, yeah, kita boleh agakkan apakah main point dalam conclusions dia atau discussion dia. And of course dengan teaser tu kita akan very excited to read, enjoy the whole thesis. Ya, yeah. Kita baca all this teaser dulu, followed by kita baca meat dia. Alright, the question is the meat tu substantial and satisfying? Dagingnya, daging thesis tersebut ataupun meat thesis tersebut adakah memuaskan dan cukup, ya? Yeah? So kita akan go through methodology dia, result dia and discussion dia. Lepas tu, lepas kita go through methodologinya ke satu persatu, right? Kita juga tak tengok lagi. Apa yang berlaku adalah kita akan tuliskan komen dekat each methodology dia, resultnya, discussion and conclusionnya. Alright, when going through this part, the evaluator should assess that the methodology employs are suitable to achieve the objective. Methodology dia betul atau tidak, but that's the main thing. Without a proper methodology, semua orang tahu the result doesn't make any sense, the conclusion also will not make any sense, yeah, and the result are substantial and presented in logical and systematically, and the data set are discussed well. Lepas tu kita go into discussion are based on the research objective tersebut dan juga based on the correct methodology, the result are discussed in correctly throughout and coherently. So we have to ask whether the candidate is well versed with the underlying theory dan display mastery in confident. Then we can, daripada resultnya, daripada discussionnya, we can see the novelty of the finding and the contributions to the new knowledge. So basically, adakah kita convince dengan metodologi, dengan result dan discussion yang dia tuliskan tersebut. Okay. Next steps adalah kita look at the beautifier, ya. Yeah? Beautifier including introductions, ya, yeah? Literature review, format and languages references and also supplementary data lah. Alright, dalam introductions kita dalam introduction biasanya kita akan dapat tahu candidate your mastery or relevant overarching principle dan also literature review display the depth, breadth and currentness of the candidate knowledge on the around the subject. Alright, because this will lead nicely to the meat tadi, yeah. Then format and languages, references and other supplementary data. Alright, so kita tengok yang itu dahulu dan insyaAllah dah habis tu kita terus tulis dekat thesis yang kita buat. Kita tulis komen dia dan kita terus masukkan kepada borang yang diberikan. Ya, guided assessment form. Kalau UiTM lah, kalau universiti lain mungkin ada form-form yang berbeza ataupun tiada form. Alright, so saya rasa kita tak boleh penalize the students lah, ya, yeah, for the weaknesses dalam beautifier and the teaser jika meatnya satisfactory, ya. Yeah. Saya rasa yang penting dalam tiga-tiga perkara ini adalah meatnya, dan apabila kita membuat concluding statement tu yang isi sama ada major, minor dan sebagainya, you have to look mainly dekat dia punya meat tu sama ada ini satisfying ataupun tidak. Kalau tak ada then you can write accordingly lah. Tapi kalau beautifiernya, reference-nya kurang, for example, atau format-nya tak betul, I think personally I think that student should not be penalized lah. Saya tahu dalam presentation selalunya during Viva Voce, student selalu kena komen kata, kenapa format ni tak betul? Alright, sebab komen, format ni memang perlu betul, tetapi nanti selepas finalize nanti, kita pelajar perlu dihantar untuk thesis formatting dan formatnya akan dibetulkan. We have to more concerned about the meat ataupun the apa tu main important point, yeah. Alright. Okay, an open assessment atau comment, yeah, dekat borang UiTM tu selalunya ada open assessment. We can write comment ataupun additional comment for each sections yang kita beri comment itu. Dan selalunya apa yang berlaku, comment tu kadang-kadang banyak kita tulis. Ya, banyak kita tulis tetapi kita tak tulis dalam borang tu. Apa yang kita boleh buat, kita write comment in the thesis itself, tapi dalam open assessment tu kita boleh draw attention dekat written formal report tu, dekat thesis tersebut. For example, sila rujuk page 32 untuk komen yang lanjut. So sebab thesis ini akan diberi balik kepada pelajar. So apa yang berlaku dalam open assessment tu, kita dah write komennya dan dalam thesis juga ada komennya. So student boleh jadikan dua perkara ini sebagai panduan pembetulan. Dan kita mesti give clear and specific comment lah, page by page jika perlulah. Right, dan juga give due credits lah. For example, kalau you rasa introduction itu bagus, give some credit. Saya rasa kita perlu tulis introduction-nya bagus, methodology-nya betul and things like that. Yeah, try not to terrorize ataupun belittle candidates lah. Right, so last thing adalah kita only recorded comment and suggestion will be addressed. Kalau dalam Viva itu, dia tidak tulis komennya. Dalam written comment, dalam thesis tak ada apa-apa, tapi dalam Viva pula banyak cerita dia. Alright, komen aja banyak. Banyak beri feedback saja, tetapi dalam return ni tidak. So apa yang berlaku, kita ada minute recorder yang kita masukkan. Kadang-kadang apa yang berlaku dalam minute recorder pun termiss. So apa yang berlaku, pembetulan hanya berdasarkan apa yang ditulis sahaja. Apa yang dicakap tetapi tidak ditulis tidak akan masuk dalam pembetulannya. Alright, so peringatan kepada saya dan semua, I think it's better to record all comment and suggestion, then that should be addressed lah. Jika kita tak bother to write it down, just hold your peace. Okay. Alright, nombor dua adalah evaluations during the Viva Voce. Alright, during the Viva Voce, kita boleh ask questions ataupun clarifications, ya. Yeah? Ask question and clarifications daripada candidate to assist determining and verifying whether the result, arguments and information presented in the thesis, and pelajar boleh defend. Basically, we can ask many questions ataupun ask for clarifications dalam tu. So apabila clarification tu diberikan, ya. Yeah, dan kita boleh alter the initial decision tadi. Mula-mula yang report yang kita berikan kepada Ketua Pusat Pengajian Siswa Azhar, KPPS tu, mungkin major. Ya, yeah? Tetapi selepas student explain, ya, yeah, kita mungkin nak tukar kepada minor. Yes, it is allowed. Ianya dibenarkan dan akan dibincangkan dan diberikan keputusan after the deliberation. So apa yang written ini tidaklah final lagi. Okay. Alright. Of course to make recommendations for improvement of the thesis. Alright. Okay. Terima kasih, itu sahaja daripada saya. Setengah jam, 20 minit. 30 minit.
Okay, thank you Dr. Hassan for the very fruitful insight on how to evaluate TCs. Is there any question from participants? Dr. Hassan, someone yeah. has asked on your slide. Can you share your slide later?
Sure.
Okay.
Kita akan jadi organizer.
Okay. Alright. Any more questions? Okay. Okay, if there's no questions, I have a question, Dr. Kisan, if you
Yeah.
mind your experience. Certainly, we have one candidate doing his PhD viva voce, and the report itself is stated by the examiners major corrections.
Sure.
Okay, and somehow after the deliberations during the viva voce, the panel has decided to give the candidate a minor.
Okay.
So it could be done as
yes.
Well? I see.
Yes, it can be done during the deliberations, the internal, external, and also kalau PhD ada oversee punya feedback, the initial decision can be altered from major kepada minor and so on, ataupun daripada minor kepada major. Tapi
okay.
Depends on the student. Sometimes student good in written, dia tulis bagus, cantik, tapi presentation memang hancur. Taklah hancur, like they are not really good in presenting materials, tapi they are written well. Some student kita tahu bahawa presentation skill dia bagus, very impressed. Dia punya PowerPoint very impressed, tapi kontennya tu susah sikit. Some people can talk but cannot write, some people can write but cannot talk. Tapi tak apalah, kita boleh juggle between this and provide the conclusions ataupun final decisions.
Okay. One more thing. I like the way you actually grab some attention by explaining on the teaser, the beautifier and the meat itself. So during the evaluations, if there's a scenario hypothetically, if it's good, but the language is out, okay, and the panel has decided to give the candidates a major correction, is there any possibility to given a student's major corrections because of that glitch?
Indeed a good questions. Can we shall we quote unquote penalize student because they can't write a good English?
Yeah.
All right. Okay, before di fakulti kami, apa yang berlaku adalah is often we encourage and sort of make it compulsory for the students, for supervisor to send the thesis for proofreader, proofreading.
Okay.
Yeah, proofreading, and kita insist on attaching the confirmation atau letter of proofreading. Therefore, dalam viva atau semasa itu, issue language, issue grammar tak keluar.
I see.
Alright. Tapi betul juga, bila grammarnya tidak betul, sentence constructions tidak bagus, kontennya tak boleh di, what they call this, tak boleh disampaikan dengan bagus. Yeah. The deliberation, the way they write, kontennya tak bagus, therefore will influence the whole thing. Yeah. Memang saya tahu ada some lecturer atau examiner give major because of grammatical error, English and so on. Tapi saya rasa benda itu tak sepatutnya berlaku, dan thesis itu tidak patut dihantar. Ya, tidak patut dihantar untuk evaluation. Saya pernah dapat thesis daripada luar negara. Sorry, saya pernah dapat laporan daripada examiner luar negara. Ya, ada kata grammatical error. This thesis should not be sent. Ya, so
okay.
Teruk lah. Memang dia kasi major because of the. Tetapi saya encourage kita hantar kepada proofreader, dan saya selalunya akan hantar kepada student link to certified proofreader. Certified proofreader mesti bayar, dan saya rasa IFSIS mungkin boleh bantu dari segi mencadangkan a good proofreader. Itulah jawapan saya.
There's one question by Wong Yud Yen. I would like to ask your opinion on the criteria that the thesis is rated as pass with minor or pass with major. What are the differences, Dr. Akisan?
Well, indeed, a good question. I like the questions. Macam mana nak mana evaluate minor atau major ni? Technically, minor ni, dia minor-minor mistake. Tidak memerlukan reanalysis semula, cuma touching up here and there, additional references. Ya, mungkin some formatting yang tak betul, sentence construction yang tak betul. Tetapi once you go into kena tambah data, kena 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 buat reanalisis balik. Objektifnya kena align dengan discussionnya, discussionnya tak tambah ah, yang tu memang confirm akan dapat major. Sebab dia memerlukan banyak panjang masa untuk re-evaluate balik semula atau rewrite semula objektifnya. Dalam discussionnya kena align dengan objektifnya, so kena buat balik semula. So kita akan berikan major based on that criteria. Ya, yeah, kalau cut off pointnya senang, kalau student perlu reanalyze balik, apa tu, tulis tambah additional chapter, dia punya conceptual framework dia salah, methodologinya salah, definitely resultnya salah, discussionnya pun salah, either fail ataupun major. Tapi fahamlah, kalau kita nak kasih fail tu agak human nature kan. Tetapi kita kasihlah major with or without VIBA. Selalunya kita major with VIBA, satu tahun untuk pembetulan. So itulah, kalau minor tu yang sikit-sikit saja, grammar, sentence constructions, paging, appendices, letak additional references, ya. Yeah. Yang frameworknya tu semua betul, cuma beautifier dia tu saja yang tidak perfect. So kita boleh kita boleh kasih dia minor. Basically kalau beautifier dia, teaser dia tak cantik tu, kita boleh kasih minor. Tapi kalau midnya tu teruk ataupun tidak memuaskan, tidak mencapai tahap, kita kasihlah major.
Okay.
Itu apa saya.
Okay. Okay, we can see the differences between pass with minor, pass with major. How about pass with no corrections and pass with minor? You know, I think, okay, the differences could be blurred. You know, sometimes a very small glitch, okay, a student can be given pass with minor, even though the mistake or the correction to be made is very, very little. So how you actually define pass without corrections?
Indeed a good questions. Pass without corrections atau lulus, saya tak pernah mengalami. Sepanjang pengalaman saya jadi KPPS, saya tak pernah terima thesis yang
okay.
Pass without correction, lulus terus. Mesti ada minornya. Alright. Apa bezanya dulu? Yang pertama sekali, bezanya saya rasalah. Okay, hanya grammatical error tak ada masalah, mungkin formatnya sahaja, right? Dan as examiner, rasa nak kasih pass with major, yeah, tentu komennya tak ada, semuanya bagus. Dan you know, kalau dah bagus tu, biasanya examiner ataupun ada student atau supervisornya kata, betul ke ni? Dan as examiner, aku rasa macam I don't know, somehow rather kena cari juga mana yang boleh di komen. Selalunya, okay, apa yang berlaku adalah selalunya structure-nya mungkin betul, content-nya bagus, apa lagi, content-nya bagus, meet dia betul, beautifier dia pun cantik. Dia start commenting on, okay, format tak betul, ED tak ada, titik salah, ini paging dia kena betul, letak page seterusnya, all the minor little thing dia akan cakap during Viva Bose ataupun dalam written examiner. Tapi kalau writtennya banyak tapi kasih pass pass straight away, ada sesuatu tak kena. Dan as examiner rasanya macam tak buat kerja lah, kalau honestly saya kata. Kalau you tak give any comment kan, semuanya good. Dan selalunya examiner to be safe lah, dan saya, ya, dia akan kasih minor. Sebab minor ni untuk UiTM dia 6 bulan pembetulan. Ya, 6 bulan pembetulan, some university 3 bulan, ya. So apa yang berlaku dalam within 6 months ni, kalau student boleh betulkan 2 hari, dia boleh hantar. Satu minggu pun boleh hantar. Hari ini betulkan, besok hantar pun untuk pembetulan pun boleh juga. Hanya ya, 6 bulan tu. Tak perlu tunggu 6 bulan baru habis baru hantar. So basically to be safe, examiner akan letak minor. Kalau dia tak boleh comment the meet, comment and the beautifier, paging tak betul, what you call this, tablesnya tak betul and so on. Yang itu kita dah tahu kalau dalam Viva, examiner dah start commenting tu, saya kata alhamdulillah macam tu. Ini either minor ataupun tak ada correction. Kalau start commenting on methodology the meet tu, discussion, dia punya conclusion, dia punya review, ini masalah besar.
Okay.
Kalau dalam examination tu atau dalam bosi dia start commenting, paging tak betul, ini ED tak ada, apa tu, graf ni sepatutnya letak dekat page channel. Okay, alhamdulillah, terus. Right, that's okay. A very good sign lah, sebab dia, I think as an evaluator, you have to find, ya, nak tak tahulah Malaysian culture, you have to find mistake. Kita find apa yang tak ada instead of apa yang ada. Just to put it keputusan. Tapi bergantung pada individu jugalah. Not everyone, I guess.
Okay, one more question, Dr. Akisan. If a student been given pass with major correction and reviva, okay, by all means, the thesis need to be improved a lot.
Yep.
And the candidate will be given a year to do the corrections.
Sure.
Okay. So in your perspective,
yeah,
in your perspective, can that thesis be upgraded from my pass with major and reviva to, you know, the level of pass with minor corrections?
Boleh. Pengalaman saya ada yang major with viva, lepas dia viva balik semula, dia dapat minor balik semula. Dan lepas hantar kepada, dah minor tu betulkan balik semula, lepas tu hantar kepada examiner lagi, kali pertama, bukan kali pertama, kali kedua lah. Apa tu, examiner komen lagi, betulkan lagi. Lepas tu hantar kali ketiga, ketiga kali hantar kepada examiner, perkara yang sama pun pernah berlaku juga. Sama rather. Boleh berlaku dan juga daripada major. Sebab apabila viva kali pertama itu, examiner dah komen semua yang bagus dah dalam thesis ni, dalam dia dah komen semua dalam thesis. So apa yang berlaku, the more detail you comment, the more easy for the students to make amendment. Dia akan tulis satu persatu, ini dah tukar, ini dah tukar, okay, ini dah betulkan and so on. Tetapi apa yang berlaku, bila hantar balik kepada examiner, ada lagi yang tak dibetulkan ataupun ada yang timbul isu-isu baru pula yang tidak tulis. So kita kira ataupun tidak tu. Yeah, that thing that you have to consider lah. Memang ada daripada major with viva, lepas tu dapat major lagi sekali, dapat minor lah. Lepas tu tanpa viva, lepas tu hantar balik pun kena betulkan lagi. Yeah, it is possible. Tetapi it is for the sake of scholarly. Kita nak baiki student, bukan nak penalize students kan. So apa yang berlaku kalau kita tulis exactly apa yang student perlu lakukan dalam thesis ini, tulis apa-apa tajuknya, bilik, ganti, change to something else. The more detail, the more better for the students to rectify. Tapi some apa yang berlaku bila thesis ni kita minta balik daripada examiner, kita tengok thesis ni cantik aja. Tak ada bertanda-tanda pun, tak ada mark-mark pun. Dan ada yang terlebih, ada banyak stiker-stiker tepi-tepi ni, banyak stiker. Yang itu mungkin terlebih baca, which is very, very good lah. So easy for the student to evaluate. Ada yang dalam borang ni tak ada apa-apa, tapi dalam ni banyak. So student nak ikut mana? Dan dia tak refer. Student akan ikut yang ini tau. Yang evaluation dia tak tengok ini lagi dah. Right, sebab yang ini, yang ini kita tak simpan. Kita tak, apa tu, fakulti tak simpan, dan student can simply say, thesis yang dibetulkan oleh examiner tu hilang. Yang ada hanya borang ini. Sebab kita pun simpan borang itu, correction based on this borang. Tapi kalau borang ini rujuk kepada yang ini, student cannot say anything. So my point is try to write detail correction as much as possible di dalam borang pembetulan, dalam report and also dalam thesis ini. So every time you baca, you comment, you tulis straight away. Jadi senang for the student buat pembetulan. Dan pembetulannya exactly as requested or as written by the examiner. So tak ada discrepancy lagi lah. Very good.
Okay. All right. Maybe one last question, Doctor. So the nature in UiTM, we have three examiners to be appointed for thesis evaluation, especially at PhD level. One is internal examiner within UiTM. Another one is external examiner, both from local and international.
Yes.
So the daunting part is actually to give results from these three panels, where they can actually give a mixture of minor, and then another panel give major, another one will be given major as well.
Yeah.
So, in your experience, how far can this actually bring troubles to students?
Okay. The discussion to give about the result of major, minor, lulus, and so on is after presentations and also deliberations or discussions during masa tu student tak ada dah, student kita minta keluar dan we all discuss the deliberations. Tapi saya agak pasti bahawa the main decisions will depends on external rather than internal.
Okay.
Kita akan consider external lebih daripada internal, which is overseas and also external within Malaysia ada university. Mereka akan diberi priority dan mereka akan beri keputusan, dan keputusan mereka itu biasanya dihormati. However, pengerusi boleh discuss lah balik semula. Pengerusi of course memainkan peranan penting dalam proses verbose itu tersebut, dan dia akan cuba untuk coordinate all these three opinions dan come up with one conclusions. Yeah. Personally, to be safe, sama ada major atau minor, di UiTM, the only differences adalah dia punya, of course, dia punya pembetulan dan durations of the pembetulan. Kalau personally, saya rasa kalau sama ada nak kasih major atau minor, alright, to be safe, kasih major pun tak mengapa, sebab major 12 bulan. Ya, minor 6 bulan. Kalau dalam masa major tu 12 bulan, dia boleh siapkan dalam masa 2 minggu atau 2 bulan, boleh juga. Kalau minor 6 bulan, tapi banyak pembetulan, banyak pembetulan perlu dibuat, lebih daripada 6 bulan, dah satu isu pula. Student tak hantar thesis, pembetulan. Dah terpaksa buat rayuan di JKIPA, so JCAPS, dan JK IPA agak-agak reluctant untuk kasih extension of 6 bulan ataupun 12 bulan tersebut. Just to be safe, kasih 12 bulan, major, tapi student can send anytime. Dan of course, student akan rasa, alamak, dah buat major. Tapi betulan sikit saja sebenarnya dia sedih, cakap dengan kawan. Saya selalu reminded the student, you jangan risau, dalam you punya scroll tak ada tulis ijaz, betul, PhD, pembetulan major, tak ada. PhD is PhD. Nobody knows sama ada you except yourself and your students, your supervisors, sama ada you major ataupun minor. And it doesn't matter much. Kalau satu tahun major pun, you boleh betulkan dalam masa 2 bulan, boleh hantar. Kalau the minor pun 6 bulan, you boleh hantar 2 minggu pun, boleh juga. So might as well kasih major, jadi student ada masa untuk berbetulan. Tetapi apa yang berlaku bila kita kasih major 6-12 bulan, dia terlebih pula. Makin banyak pembetulan dia nak buat. Padahal pembetulan sikit, bukan banyak pembetulan, dia takes a longer time for them to apa tu, complete the correction. Selalu saya cakap dengan my student, okay, you have about 1 month to do correction, no more, no less. Alright, let's sit down together and do some corrections together. Go through correction. Hari-hari buat. So make sure within a month, siap correction regardless whether major ataupun minor. Targetnya macam itu. So depends on the examiner lah. Kalau you are in the feeling of major or minor, you have to consider student feeling, you have to consider the duration, might as well give major because extra time for the students to make changes. Itu jawapan saya.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Hassan.
Terima kasih.
Okay, I think there's no more questions from participants. Okay, all participants, please sign up the attendance field form at the chat box posted by Dr. Aman Muhammad Ihsan Mahmud. Slides will be given to all of us by Dr. Akisan later, I believe. It will be generated over a QR code to retrieve the slides. We are 9 minutes to 11. I think we can actually wrap up the sessions. Any last word from you, Dr. Akisan?
Tak ada. Terima kasih. Terima kasih kerana beri peluang. Saya minta maaf kalau saya tidak up to your expectation. Yeah. Bila Ipsis give me the topic, I was like, okay. Saya ingatkan untuk student. So saya kata, okay, tak mengapa. Then I found out ianya untuk semua top level. Dan bila saya go through dia punya speaker tu, yeah, ada tak aman kalau you dengar. Semuanya professor, associate professor. Saya rasa sangat little dan saya rasa sangat kecil. Dan but anyway, saya cuba juga dan terima kasih kepada ISIS kerana beri saya peluang. Thank you very much.
Okay, on the behalf of all participants, we would like to thank you, Dr. Akisan, for giving a very wonderful experience. And we would like to take this opportunity to thank ISIS as well to be given a platform for everyone of us to share our knowledge. Perhaps to see you again, Dr. Akisan, in the next slot, just like this. Okay, okay, guys, I think it's almost 11. I think we can wrap up the sessions. Thank you for joining us. Until then, thank you.